Hello everyone, this lecture video is all about ATP production from the complete oxidation of glucose. So, in previous lectures, we have noted that the one reduced coenzyme flavin adenine dinucleotide dihydrogen is equivalent and will produce 1.5 adenosine triphosphate. And one guanine triphosphate will produce one adenosine triphosphate. Then one reduced form of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide hydrogen will produce 2.5 ATP or ATP molecules. So, but there are instances, and I would like you to take note that the reduced nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide that is produced in the cytosol cannot directly participate in the electron transport chain because the mitochondria is impermeable to reduced nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide and oxidized nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. So, for this NADH to participate in the process, a transport system shuttles the electrons of the nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, but not the nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, the reduced form itself, across the outer membrane. This shuttle involves the dihydroxyacetone phosphate and the glycerol 3-phosphate. So the consequence of this reaction, instead of the normal NADH that will produce a 2.5 ATP, the cytosol NADH or the cytosol reduced nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide will only produce 1.5 rather than 2.5 molecules of ATP. So here is the overall production of ATP from the complete oxidation of one glucose molecule in a skeletal muscle cell. So these are the reactions, the comments, and the yield of ATP. So for glycolysis, we will be consuming 1 ATP in the production of glucose, the glucose 6-phosphate, because as you can see here, the glucose does not have phosphate, but the product here in this stage will produce phosphate at the 6-carbon. And then this fructose 6-phosphate will be converted to fructose 1,6-biphosphate, and it will consume 1 ATP. Because as you can see here, the phosphate here is only at 6-carbon, but at the end product, we now have 2 phosphate which are located at the 1st and 6-carbon. So in the cleavage of the fructose 1,6-biphosphate, you will have the dihydroxyacetone, right, and the glyceraldehyde. So the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, we will have 2 pieces of that because the dihydroxyacetone from the step 5 will be converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. You have here 2 pieces of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, and the end product will be 1,3-biphosphoglycerate. It will involve a 1-cytosolic NADH, and we wouldn't be consuming ATP here. So from this process here, the next step is the 1,3-biphosphoglycerate here, the 2 pieces of that, because you have 2 pieces here, it will produce 3-phosphoglycerate. So the phosphate here in the one on the 1st carbon will be removed, therefore you will be producing 1 ATP. So here, if you consume, that is minus 1. If you will produce, that is plus 2. This is plus 2 because you have 2 here, 2 units. Okay? And then next, you have here the 2 pieces of phosphenylpyruvate will be converted to 2 pieces of pyruvate. And each pieces will produce 1 ATP. So you have here 2 pieces of ATP yield. The next step is the oxidation of pyruvate. You have here 2 pieces of pyruvate, which is will produce acetyl-CoA plus carbon dioxide gas. Each will produce 1 NADH. Okay, there will be no yield of ATP for that because that will undergo the electron transport chain. Next is the citric acid cycle. 2 pieces of isocitrate will produce alpha-ketoglutarate, and each will produce 1 NADH again that will not yield ATP right away. It has to undergo the electron transport chain. Same with the production of 2 pieces of alpha-ketoglutarate to succinyl-CoA plus carbon dioxide. Each molecules will produce 1 NADH, but again, that will not yield ATP directly or right away, so that is that needs to undergo an electron transport chain. And then the 2 pieces of succinyl-CoA will be converted to succinate, and each will produce 1 guanine triphosphate, and 1 guanine triphosphate will be converted directly into 1 piece of ATP, but since we have here 2 pieces of the molecule, that is plus 2 here for the ATP. And then next, for the 2 pieces of the succinate that is converted into fumarate, each will produce 1 flavin adenine dinucleotide hydrogen. this one will undergo the electron transport chain before be converted into ATP. And here, the two pieces of malate, which will be converted into the regenerated oxaloacetate, will produce one reduced nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, again, that needs to undergo an electron transport chain and oxidative phosphorylation before to be converted into an ATP. So now let us proceed here in the electron transport chain and oxidative phosphorylation. Here we have here the two cytosolic NADH formed in glycolysis, this one. You have here the two pieces, right? Okay, but that's not able to produce an ATP because it needs to undergo an ATP production from the electron transport chain. So the two cytosolic NADH here formed in the glycolysis will produce 1.5 ATP instead of 2.5 because it came from cytosol. So if you will multiply that is 1.5 times 2, that is plus 3 here in the yield of the ATP. Then next, the two pieces of the NADH here formed in the oxidation of pyruvate, each will produce 2.5 ATP because the pyruvate here will enter mitochondrial matrix, right, in the inside of the cell. So that will produce plus 5 here, 2.5 times 2, that is plus 5. And then the two pieces of flavine adenine dinucleotide dihydrogen here will form in the citric acid cycle, each will produce 1.5 ATP. So you will multiply 1.5 times 2, that will be plus 3 here. This one. And then here next, the six pieces of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide hydrogen formed in the citric acid cycle, each will produce 2.5 ATP because the citric acid cycle occurs in the mitochondrial matrix and not in the cytosol. So each is equivalent to 2.5 instead of the reduced 1.5. And if you will multiply, that is 2.5 times 6, that is equivalent to 15 pieces of the ATP yield here. So the net production of ATP here, if you will compute this, that is plus 30. This occurs in skeletal muscle cells. So therefore, one glucose that will undergo a complete oxidation in skeletal muscle cells will produce 30 pieces or 30 molecules of ATP yield. And the next, the 30 ATP molecules per glucose is for those cells where the dihydroxyacetone phosphate glycerol 3-phosphate shuttle operates, which occurs in skeletal muscles and nerve cells. This shuttle here is the one that transports the electrons from the NADH. But in some cells, particularly where the malate aspartate shuttle functions, primarily this occurs in heart and liver muscles, instead of having only 1.5 ATP from cytosolic NADH, here in malate aspartate shuttle, we will produce the exact 2.5 ATP molecules from one cytosolic NADH. So it will change the production to 32 molecules per glucose. So because here in this part here in the cytosolic, you have here your 3, right? But if you will add another one times 2 here, that is plus 2. So that is why you have 32 molecules per glucose in cells where malate aspartate shuttle functions, that is in heart and liver muscles, because they need to readily produce abruptly an energy. So that is all for the ATP production from the complete oxidation of glucose.